So basically today we discuss a which one topic. Topic name is IP address. Clear? So right now basically first day we discuss theory part, then we start subnetting part. Clear? Basically, what is the meaning of IP? IP called Internet Protocol. Clear? An address, it's a numerical. Yes or no? Numerical, or you can say hexadecimal format also available. Which one format? Hexadecimal. Numerical or hexadecimal. Basically, how many types IP address available basically? Anyone know how many types? You have two types. First, IPv4, and second, IPv6. Basically, today we discuss only IPv4. Clear? IPv6 we discuss separate. Clear? Okay. Now, IPv4 called Internet Protocol version 4. Which one? Internet Protocol version 4. Okay, right now one more thing. This one is a which type of address? Logical address. Okay, right now you can also say IPv4 address, you can see it's a numerical address. Which one? Numerical. Okay, one more thing. Basically, this address are provided by AINA. AINA called Internet Assigned Number of Authority. Clear? One more thing. IPv4 address a size, single address size, or you can say total address size. How many bits? 32 bits. Okay. Right now, in a one byte, how many bits present? 8 bit. Can you please tell me in 32 bits, how many bytes present? Mukulji, Rajendra ji, Ibrahim. How many byte? 4 byte. A total is 4 byte. One more thing. How to know which one is IPv4 address? So for example, this one is IP address. 1.2.3.4. This one is IP address, for example. So right now, how many departments available? 1, 2, 3, and this one is 4. So how many? A 4. So basically an IPv4 called 4-octet. How many octet? 4-octet. This one is first, second, third, and this one is fourth. 4-octet available. Okay, one more thing in IPv4. 1-octet size eight bit. That means a 4-octet size, how many bits? 32. Clear? Okay, one more thing for IPv4. If I am putting a short formula for 8 bits, formula is 2 power, how many bits in 1 octet? 8 bit. So you are getting how many values? 256. Okay, right now one more thing. IPv4. Basically, range start in 1 octet, how many range available? How many values? From 0 to 255 in 1 octet. You can put the values 0 to 255. Okay, one more theory for IPv4. IPv4 divided into class. You can say classes. divided into classes. Okay, right now how many class available? So basically here I'm just write down class and then range. So basically first class name is A, and A class range start from 0 to 127. Suppose if you are getting a 4 box, this one is 1 octet, 2 octet, 3 octet, and this one is 4 octet. So right now basically in 1 octet, how many values put from 0 to 255? Okay, right now in first octet, if you are getting 0 to 127 in between values, so which one class belong? Class A. If you are getting class B, a value is 128 to 191. Class C, 192 to 223. Class D, 224 to 239. Class E, 240 to 255. Clear? This thing is clear? Any doubt? Okay. Basically, class E already reserved for research. For research. Okay, right now one more class reserved. Which one? Class D. This one also reserved. Why? For multicasting. Suppose if you are going for CCNP, so we will discuss in CCI, CCNP, we will discuss why we use multicasting. Clear? Okay. Right now, how many class in use for CCNA student? Class A, class B, and class C. Suppose if you are getting a new technology, suppose right now Tesla is most important. Yes or no? Anyone know Tesla? A Tesla deploy a new cars, satellites, from satellites. So how Tesla are testing for the cars? So Tesla also use this class of addresses for research purpose. Suppose if you are getting a new technology, which one? Cloud. So cloud first test on which one addresses? Class E addresses. So this address always used for a research purpose, never used for industry, a production network, real time data centers. Clear? Only for research. This address only for research. If you're trying to assign this address on your network interface card, so never get. Okay, this thing is clear. Suppose right now go to ncpa.cpa and write down any network adapter, this one. Close this one and go to IPv4 property, obtain, use the following and write down. Suppose if I am trying to assign 245, so which one? Read the error. 245 is not a valid entry. Please specify a value between 1 and 223. Only range, valid range is 1 to 223. So this value already fits. Only for research purpose, class E use. Okay, only for research purpose. So you can use in real time only. Which one class is? A, B, or C. How to use class D, we discussed in CCNP or CCNP. Right now, this one is research purpose or multicasting. Those classes reserved. Okay, right now, one more thing. We discuss one more information. Reserved address information. Okay, right now in class A, zero number range. Suppose if any IP is starting from zero, so this zero number range already reserved for DHCP process. Which one process? DHCP. Basically, DHCP provide automatic IP address. Suppose if you are going for metro, any malls, so you are getting a free Wi-Fi connection. So how to get IP address from servers? So this one range help to get IP address from DHCP server. So this DHCP server provide automatic IP. So zero address also reserved. Right now, one more, 127. If you are getting a 127 starting IP, this one also already reserved. Already reserved for loopback. If you don't want to learn for loopback, you can say for NIC card. Which one card? NIC card. NIC card means network interface card. Network interface card means your LAN card, your WAN adapter as well. Clear? So if you want to verify your LAN adapter is working or not working, any hardware issue, any software issue, so just try to ping on this address. Which one? 127.0.01. This address for testing your LAN card, your WAN card, it's working or not working. So right now try to ping CMD, ping 127.0.0.1. Enter. If you are getting a reply, that means a LAN card or WAN card are working properly. If you are getting a request time out, that means adapter is not working. Clear? So any hardware issue, any software issue, you can try to ping this one. Clear? Basically, if you're trying to assign this range address on your network interface card as an IP address, so never assign. Verify. Go to any network adapter. Which one? IPv4 property. Click on obtain. Then again, suppose if I am starting from zero, I'm trying to assign 0. So read the error. Zero is not a valid entry. That means please specify a value between 1 and 223. Suppose if you are thinking, sir, 127 is allowed because in between 1 and 223 value is available. So right now, write down your address 127. Read the error. IP address starting with 127 are not valid because they are reserved for loopback address. Please specify some other values between 1 and 223. Clear? So that is the reason. Developer already fixed this addresses 0 or 127. Clear? This type of address never assign on your network interface card. Clear? Okay. That means in class A valid range from this one. This one is not a valid range. Valid range is 1 to 126. Which one? 1 to 126. And class B, 128 to 191. And class C, 192 to 223. Now second task, a very simple. How to identify IP address, which class? Rajendra ji, clear? How to identify IP address of which class? Suppose, for example, if I'm write down 1.1.1.1, because only 4 octet, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Right now, anyone know which class of address I'm using right now? This one. Anyone know which class?
Class A.
Class A. Very good. Suppose if I am write down 115.1.1.1. Which class address this one?
Again, it is A.
Again, class A. Very good. Again, suppose if I am write down 139.1.1.1. Then, if you need to verify the range, no worry. You can verify. You can take
class B.
This one is class B because 128 to 191. Okay. Right now, suppose if you are getting 196, 1 dot, 1 dot, 1. Which one class?
Class C.
Class C.
Okay. So right now, some student will get easily, but someone issues. So right now, very simple trick. If you want to learn, always check. First octet values. How many values are in first octet? Only in between 0 to 255. Yes or no? So this one is 1. This one is 115. This one is 139. This one is 196. Okay, right now, suppose if I am write down this one. Anyone know which class of address I am using? This one.
It is class A.
That's going to be a class A.
Class A. Always verify only first octet value. Never check second, third, or fourth. Always first octet. A very simple. Because in first octet only, this values will be fixed. If any possibility available, if I am write down 256, 1 dot, 1 dot, 1. No, this one is wrong. Because inside one octet, I am getting 8 bits. So 8 bit value is 256. But valid range start from 0 to 255. Clear this thing? Okay. Right now, one more point. Basically, Aina provide every class fix network octet. Which one octet? Network octet. Network means for group. For group use. Inside group, you are getting multiple users, na? Yes or no? So same. A group means network. For network concept, every class, which one organization define? Aina. Okay. Aina also define every class free host octet. Which one octet? Host octet means users. How many users you can fix in octet? So basically, network means group and host means a user. Inside group, how many users available? So basically, how many class available? A, B, C. Yes or no? Okay. Then we discuss range. Then we discuss fix octet for which one? Network. Then we discuss free octet for which one concept? Host. Okay. Host means user and network means a group. Very simple. Right now I'm creating a box. Okay. So right now this one is box ready. Okay. Here I'm just write down class. Then we write down range. Then we write down octet. Then this one is okay. Right now basically first class name is, anyone know first class name is which one?
A.
Class A. Okay. Yeah. Valid range is 1 to
127.
126. 127 is reserved. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. In IPv4, how many octets available? Four.
For
network. For network already. Class A. One octet fixed. How many octet fixed here? One octet fixed. Four. Network. Clear? Okay. How many octet remaining now for host? How many octet?
Three
octet free. For host. That means user can use. Yes or no? By default. Okay. Right now, second, which one class? B. A valid range is 128 to 191. Okay, in class B, Aina Fix, how many octet? 2 octet fix for network. And how many octet remaining, Razik? How many octet remaining now after 2 octet?
6, 2.
2 octet free. Because only 4 octet available, na? 2 octet free, 4. Post portion. Okay. Right now, which one class remaining? Class C. Okay. Class C range is 192, 2 to 3. Okay. Right now in class C also 4 octet, but right now Aina fix 3 octet for group use. Already fix. Okay, now how many octet remaining after 3? How many octet remaining? 1 octet free for host. Host means a user can use for IP address. Yes or no? And network octet never use. Clear? By default. This thing is clear? Any doubt? Class A, class B, class C. Clear? Okay. Right now, one more thing. Same diagram we draw, but now Aina provide total IP address. Total IP address. On the basis of which one octet? Free octet. Which one octet dear? Free octet. So right now, same thing we do. Copy this diagram. Simple. Copy this one only. Okay. Copy this one. And we need to create one more box. So here we write down total IP address. Clear? Okay. Right now, basically, first clear, this one is class A information. Which one information? Mukulji, Rajendraji, class A. This one is which one class information? B. And this one is which one information? Class C. Any doubt for this one theory part? Okay. Now clear. Suppose if I am using a power formula. So right now in class A, how many octet free? Verify. Anyone know how many octet free in class A?
3.
Okay. Right now, 3 octet. Yes or no? In 1 octet, how many bits available?
8 bits.
8 bits. If I am calling 3 octet, so that means how many bits total?
24.
Then I am getting a total IP address range here. Yes or no? Okay. As it is, same process. In class B, how many octet free?
2.
2 octet. So how many total bits?
16.
After putting this formula, getting a total number of IP address. Simple. In class C, how many octet available free for host?
1.
Same formula. Power. How many bits?
8.
Okay, now use calculator. So very simple. How to use calculator for power option? Always use scientific. You can choose from this side. If you are getting by default standard, no worry. Click on this one. Use scientific to this one. XY means power. Power, how many bits? 24. So I already know 16777216 value will be come out. This one. How many total IP address in class A? Verify. How many? Admin. This one values in class A address. Yes or no? Okay. In class B, 2 power 16. 65536. That means 65,536 IP available in which class? Class B. Same. Class C, 2 power 8. How many total IP address? Rajendra ji, 250.
256.
Clear? So every class IP address concept, Aina, clear? Any doubt? Okay. One more theory. Very simple. Now IP address after IP address, Aina provide one more information. Which one? Which one, dear? Subnet mask. Okay, basically, anyone know why we use subnet mask? Any idea about subnet mask? Any idea? Razik, Edwin, Aaron, Mukulji, Ibrahim. Any idea about subnet mask?
I mean, what I know that from the company is that we just kind of do it in our company just to differentiate the different, I would say, departments from each other. Other than that, I really don't think something just kind of popping up in my head.
Okay, no one. A very simple theory for subnet mask. Very short.
The number of bits for maybe the number of bits for the network and for the host.
Okay, no issue, no issue. A very easy and short theory. Very easy. Right now, with the help of subnet mask, network admin get information regarding inside subnet mask, how many IP address available for host and how many network, that means you can say a group, how many network available? Clear? With the help of subnet mask, network admin get only two information. Which one? How many IP address and how many network? Clear? Any doubt? This thing is clear? Okay. This one is important point, but we discuss a next session. You can only read this line. Okay. With the help of subnet mask, admin also get a group information. Group means network. I think router data packet flow we discussed. A same network or different network? Yes or no? Okay. So right now, how to get subnet mask? A very simple logic. Very simple. Very simple. Okay. Right now, this diagram is clear. This one. Any doubt for this diagram? This one concept. Okay. Right now, we need to draw one more line. for subnet mask. Yes or no? So hold on. This one. So we need to create a which one? Default subnet mask information. Clear? Which one information? Ibrahim, Razi, Mugulji, Rajendraji, Edwin, Aaron. Default subnet mask information. Basically, can you please verify in class A how many octet fix? Only fix octet it. How many? In class A, how many octet fix?
One
octet. Suppose if I am calling a fix, fix means in one box, how many value put to fix from 0 to 255? Which one value fix this octet?
Yeah, 2, 0, and 255.
No, only 255. Only 255. This one is last value. No? If I am putting this value, so that means this one is fulfilled already. Yes or no? Because in one octet, only 8 bit present. No? If I am putting a 2 power 8, so I am getting a 256 and valid range is 0 to 255. If I am putting in one octet 255, that means this octet already fixed. No space available. Yes or no? So okay. Right now in class A, how many octet fixed? One octet. That means if I am write down 255, first octet. Yes or no? And how many octet free?
Three.
So that means zero, because no one fill this address. So this one is which class subnet mask? Which class? This one is class A default subnet mask. 255000. Very simple. Again, you can try for class B. Class B, very easy. Right now, read the line. How many octet fix in class B, dear? In class B, how many octet fix?
Two.
So that means how many 255 available in address? How many 255? One. This one is first octet. Second. And how many octet free? Two. Zero. Zero. So this one is which class? Which class subnet mask dear? Anyone know which class? Class B. Because right now with the help of this subnet mask, network admin know. Okay. If I'm getting 255000, that means starting two octet already fixed because I'm getting a 255. That means full values. But third and fourth is free. That means fulfill these values. Yes or no? Okay, right now, this one is class B subnet mask. Okay, right now, class C, how many octet free or how many octet fixed? Verify.
Three.
So that means how many 255? One, two, and this one is three. Three octet fixed now already for network and dot Z. So right now this one is class A subnet mask, this one is class B, and this one is which class? Which class subnet mask? Class C. Razik, Ibrahim, Mukulji, Rajendraji, Edwin, Aaron. Clear? How to create subnet mask? This thing is clear? Okay. Next point is, basically, we need to draw a small organization, you can say. We need to draw a small organization setup, or you can say home setup, any diagram. So basically, users available, multiple users, clear? And this side connected via mobile phone, this side mobile phone, and this side I am using a tab, clear? And this one is PC, 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 PC. And right now, this one is connected via which one device? Modem. Clear? Physical connectivity. And this one is wireless. This one is wireless. Clear? And modem connected via which one side? ISP side. So this one is organization setup. Basically, this side called which one? LAN, local area network. And this side called WAN, wide area network. This one is local. You can say private. Yes or no? Private area. And this one is wide area. You can say which one? Public area, basically. Clear? Okay. Most of the cases, ISP modem provide this type of address, starting with your IP address 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one more IP reserved for gateway. Which one? 0.1. Yes or no? This type address you are getting now on your home setup, offices. Yes or no? So basically, in this address, which class IP address I am using? Any idea? In this address, which class IP?
So is it C?
Class C. Very good. Okay, right now in class C, how many total IP? Anyone know how many total IP?
It's 256.
256. Okay, right now total is 256. But right now, how many devices available connected with modem? Seven devices. Suppose if I am connect 10 device, so minus 10 from 256. How many IP remaining now? How many IP remaining? Razik, Ibrahim, Mukulji, Rajendraji, Edwin, Aaron. 246 IP. That means this 246 IP waste. Not any use. Why? Any possibility in your home modem, office modem, a 246 user available to use internet services? Any possibility available? No. A daily basis, any possibilities available? No. So why we are doing IP wastage? Which type of issues I am getting for IP wastage? Suppose in this case, this PC want to communicate with this PC. So basically this PC first check app table. If entry available, then communicate. If entry not available, this user generate which one message? App request, that means which one? Broadcast, modem receive, and modem verify. How many IP address available total, dear? How many? Mukulji, Rajendraji, Ibrahim, Razik, 256. So right now modem trying to verify where is 256? Forward. And modem also trying to identify where is 246. So in this case, modem use extra CPU. Yes or no? Modem use extra CPU utilization. Network congestion also available. Yes or no? That is the reason. Most of the cases in production network, you can say, or data centers, any organization, network engineer always use which one concept, dear? Subnetting. Which one concept? Subnetting. Okay, right now, subnetting. Why we use subnetting? To save IP address wastage. Which one issue first resolve? To save IP address wastage. And one more theory for subnetting, to break a big network into a small network. Which one network, dear? To break a big network into small network. Okay, one more theory for subnetting. with the help of subnetting number of IP address limited available depends on requirement. Depends on requirement. This thing is clear, because right now if I am using class C address, and class C, how many IP available? 256. But we required only how many IP? 10 IP suppose. So how many IP address wastage? 246. So that is the reason network admin use a which one concept, Razik? Which one concept here? Subnetting. Clear? To save IP address wastage, to break a big network into a small network with the help of subnetting number of IP address limited available depends on your requirement. Clear? This thing is clear? Okay. Right now, if you want to learn a subnetting, a very easy, very easy. Subnetting. Right now, always use subnetting formula. Which one, Mukulji? Subnetting formula. Okay. Right now, subnetting formula is very simple. This one is my own formula. A very simple formula. If you want to find out anywhere, so you can find out. No one use this formula. Right now, first method. Decimal to. Which one concept? Binary. Decimal value convert into which one value? Binary. Okay. Right now, second method. After convert binary, we are getting a second step. Which one? Which one bit we are getting? A borrow bit. Third thing. Default subnet mask. Convert into customize subnet mask. Which one, dear? Default subnet mask, this one. Default subnet mask convert into which one subnet mask? Customize subnet mask. You can say this one is DSM and this one is CSM. CSM. Clear? Okay. Right now, fourth. After this process, we get one more thing. Which one? Increment bit. Then fifth, we are getting a very important point. Which one? Block size. Inside block size, we are getting three things. Which one? Network address. Valid IP address broadcast address. Clear? Okay. Network address or broadcast address. Never assign which one device is dear? End device, PC, laptop, servers. Never assign end devices. Valid IP assign. Clear? Which one device? End devices. Any doubt, Mukulji, Razik, Ibrahim? This thing is clear? Okay. Before starting submitting formula, we discuss one more theory. This one is your IP address subnetting books. Okay, hold on, verify. CC Cisco CCNA box, this one, IP address subnetting mode. This one is 57 page books, okay, total 57, 58 page books. So you can get IP address class detail here. Then this one is private or public, we discuss. But right now this one is not important, we discuss. Okay, then we discuss, okay, binary to decimal concept available, decimal to binary, okay. Address class, okay. This process escape, which one? Binary to decimal or decimal to binary? We discuss, but right now escape. You solve this one, address class identification. Okay, right now verify, which one class this one address? Which one class, anyone know? Which class address this one?
E.
Class. So you can write down here a class, very simple. Okay, next task, network and host identification. Okay, this one is also simple. Right now, circle the network portion. Okay, anyone know which class of address this one?
Class C.
Class C. So how many octet fixed for network?
Three.
One, two, three. Only three octet circle. Yes or no? And this one? Three. This one is host portion. Okay, how many octet in class C? Only one. So you can only circle one octet. Okay, right now after this one, default subnet mask. Okay, right now this one is which class address?
Class A.
So write down the class A default subnet mask. Clear? So this one is your homework. I will provide this book on your Google Drive. Clear? So you need to just print out this book and solve these questions. Clear? Then okay. We meet again Monday. Then we start a subnetting part. Clear?
Okay.
This thing is clear? Any doubt? This one is subnetting formula. You must read the formula only. Clear? Read the formula. Clear? I will provide another batch of subnetting videos. So you can go through only. Clear? So whenever we start subnetting part, so this one is easy to learn. Clear? Mukulji, Rajendraji, Ibrahim. Razi?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So we meet again.